that you have. So this is the way you build the anointing in you in prayer, so that when you get out of prayer, you can go and be very, very bold. As one of the I guess, byproducts of prayer, it always what? Makes you bold. How many sometimes you come to prayer, you come to church, you feel so depressed and downhearted and broken and, you know, in trouble. But as you pray, then your spirit man, what? Rise up. Amen. Good word, but good like a what? Medicine. Is that right? Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I'm doing everything that I can to show you that how you can actually experience a greater measure, of blessings in your prayer, in your prayer time. Amen. This is the way you do it. Build the word. When you build the word, and it's going to build your prayer language. It's going to enable you to what? Sing songs and hymns and spiritual songs and make melody. This is the way you build yourself up on your most holy faith by praying in the Holy Ghost. And one of my favorite scriptures, they which receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by Christ Jesus. You know, all of these scriptures are good, but the scripture says the word is what? Life to them that what? Find it. Everybody don't feel the same thing when you make these acknowledgments. But we have to work on it, keep building it, and sooner or later, amen, you'll begin to what? Feel the life flowing into your spirit as you begin to acknowledge the word of God in prayer. Prayer can be very boring if you don't do something to stimulate yourself. And the stimulation has to come through the word and the what? The spirit. You have to stimulate yourself. Amen. I asked Sister Shirley Brown, she has to leave every morning around 6:15. That's pretty good. She hangs from 5 to 6, from 5:45. That's pretty good, Sister Devon. About all prayer you're going to do anyway. Huh? All right, now, I was so concerned. I said, I don't want to, Sister Shirley, just to come out here and just waste her time.
Oh, no, I'm not wasting
her time. So I asked, I said, are you getting anything? You have to leave, you know, quicker than everybody. Are you getting anything out of this? I'm just trying to see, because I maybe it would be better if you'd be better off staying home sleeping.
Getting out early.
All right, so what do you get out of it? Sister Shirley, just tell us, it's just a little something you get out of it.
Well, I get energy.
All right, you get energy.
Yep.
Spiritual energy.
Things go better at work.
Things go better at work.
Some people don't
talk
to me, so I'm talking to
me. She said what? Some people don't what?
Some people, they just
don't have
anything to do with you.
Mm-hmm.
Then I start coming in the morning prayer. I know it was God.
Right. And I have to acknowledge this, that Sister Shirley, I guess 2 years ago, Sister Shirley was working how many jobs? Two or three? And it was kind of hard to find Sister Shirley, even with a search warrant. But you know, I'm telling you, she's one of the loudest ones in prayer now. Amen. Loudest one in prayer. And she just got a good spirit of understanding the women's group. She's just up teaching and going on. This person. Man, nobody ever thought Sister Shirley.
We have a good time in the women's group.
Yes, she's anointed. Yeah. Like a little evangelist, a missionary or something. She's really coming on. Amen. And she always find that seat. Is that the same seat you sit on all the time? Whatever scripture that just hits your heart button. You know, there are some scriptures that hit your heart button. Mm-hmm. So whatever scripture hits your heart button, just work with it. Woo! Whatever scripture hits your hot button, work with it. And I'm going to have to say this, Brother Al. You never see men crying broken in prayer. Yesterday, I called on him to pray, and this is what they're doing. They're calling on different ones to pray. Especially the brother, they started out. And he got up, you know, sometimes he starts out slow. He say, God of Abraham. That's all right. But before he finished that prayer, he's said about 10 or 12 scriptures. Amen. Well, I like that. And then after a while, he just cried. Yeah. Just break.
Yeah.
That's when it's getting good to you. The Bible says the word is what? Life. Hallelujah. Amen. So I want to get everybody on one accord, and we want to begin to really pray from our heart, singing in the Spirit, praying in the Holy Ghost, really enjoying it, because all of us together can do a lot. Although individually, it seems like it's very difficult to make headway individually when we begin to reach out and try to, you know, do certain things. But when we pray together and unite, amen, our prayer is going to be amplified, what? Many, 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 many times. Things that you can't accomplish just praying singly, you can accomplish and see the realization if what? All of us come and be on one accord. Amen. Jehoshaphat proved that. Even they didn't know what to do. And, you know, even in ministry now, you know, you don't know what to do. Amen. Because the obstacles are so difficult. Sometimes you don't know what direction. You don't know, amen, praise God, when to do this or what to do or whether, you know, you should do it, period. So you just have to pray until God gives you what? Direction. And God makes the way what? Plain. That's the way, what happened in Jehoshaphat's time. Jehoshaphat, we don't know what to do. All of these nations have come around us, and these people came to throw us out of our inheritance. And we were good to these folks. We had a chance to wipe them all out. But we just what? Let them go. And here they are trying to what? Wipe us out now after us, after we were so good to them. And he just laid it all on the table and said, Lord, amen, we just don't know how to handle it. We don't know what to do. But you did say, see, he went and came into agreement with God's word. He pulled up that word. He said, Lord, you said that when our enemy would come in, whether it would be a war or famine or pestilence or sword or whatever adversity would come against us, you said, if we would just all come together to your house and what? Pray that you will what? You will hear us and you will help us. And after he said that, see, they were all on what? One accord. They've been fasting and praying, and all of them had come together in agreement to pray and seek God's help and deliverance. The Bible says that they didn't know what to do. That's what he said. We don't know what to do. Don't some of us have situations that we are in? We don't know what to do. We don't have a clue as to how to fix it. Some of these people that we're working with right now, we're going to have this typed up by Sunday and give everybody a copy. I just said, Lord, I just don't know what to do about these folks. Amen. But our eyes are on you. That's what Jehoshaphat said. How many can say amen? Amen. So what we're going to do, we're going to seek God. So it takes prayer for God to give us the direction that we need to take. How to help people is not something that you just automatically get because you are a believer. You have to seek God, and God will show you how to what? How to help people. Amen. So we have people on this list that we need to connect with. Amen. All right? I want everybody to understand that. Some of these are your sweet brothers and sisters that we love very much, but many of them, amen, really need to to get into the flow. Amen. Of the Word and the Spirit. Amen. Praise God. So, this is basically, I think that it was really a blessing. I believe it was yesterday. It was a couple that was sitting right here. It was yesterday, I believe. And a young couple that we ministered to, and they did commit to come on Sunday, regardless of how tired they were, regardless of how late they got in, regardless of what circumstances might exist, they made a commitment to be at church, and they made a commitment to be here for Bible study on Tuesday evening. Amen. So there are many, many people that we can help, that we can reach, but sometimes it might be look insurmountable. All right? I'm going to let y'all, Sister Turner, Sister Hill in a minute. Now, what can we do as a body? Now, what could we do as a women's group to help people that they're not going to come here for us to help them? How can we give help to them? Women or men? Women or men, okay? I want a woman to talk now. What could we do? Now, we're praying now, but I think that we need to do a little bit more than pray. All right. Okay.
Some people are hard to reach, and it is hard to set down a time when you can meet with them in their house, so it would be best with those kind of people to have Bible study on their own.
Okay. All right, so Sister Earl, the hair was set.
Yes. I have two people like that that I'm having Bible study with on their
own. Okay, why did you come to that conclusion?
Because I tried to say, could you come to church this day, or could you come with that one, and they're always busy. Mm-hmm. So we have Bible study.
Okay. All right. Now, that's good. Now, sometimes people say, well, if I have to help people by giving them a Bible study, I just can't help them. All right? So we want to explore all options. What can we do to get through to people that are not going to show up? I'm not going to show up consistently. What can we do? Because this is opening up our bounds of compassion. But I don't want them just to miss out on everything, because life is going to be hard. The Bible says the web of transgressor is what? It's hard. And eventually, they might even miss what? Miss the mark. Going to judgment, maybe their blood will be counted, on somebody's hands. Okay, what can we do? Okay, brothers, since the women are kind of slow. I got a whole lot of brothers on here. Oh, gosh, a whole lot of brothers. Church will look good on Sunday. Yeah, all these brothers. They have them here. What can we do? Somebody said, we can just pray. We can just pray. All right, brothers, come on.
The obvious answer, Pastor, is we've got to go get them in whatever form or shape that may take. Either going over to the house, giving them a phone call, I think we mentioned emails, or just talking to them about something in general, which would lead up to just an ease of feeling amongst us, mm-hmm. and gradually getting into something a little deeper, talking mm-hmm. about God's Word, and just making them feel comfortable. So the approach has to be made in any way, shape, or form that we can do it.
Okay, the approach has to be made in any shape, form, as we can do it. All right, they like what you said.
Thank you, Ms. Sue.
Okay, let me ask this.
Let me just say it is, and we had a healthy discussion about this last Wednesday night. People are busy, you know, people here at work are busy. I don't work on an 8-to-5 job, but I'm busy. And, but I probably do have more time than people that's 8-to-5 or whatever. People have families. So as Brother Rob was saying, we have to meet people where they are. Sister Pearl was saying they can't come to church, so she does it on the phone. That's still making contact with them. And she has a Bible study with them. Some people may not be at the point where they are ready for a Bible study. You can befriend them, and you can maybe text them. You know how to text, or email them, or call them, or whatever. Use the technology that we have today. I don't mean to reduce it to, because I still think that person-to-person contact is really vital. But there are so many different ways that a busy person can greet someone. And sometimes just a quick phone call will make a difference. It doesn't have to be you stand on the hour, but sometimes you say, well, I can't call so-and-so because I only have an hour from the time and you can be all involved. And maybe 5 minutes. You know? So I think you have to look at the situation and that dictate what your approach is.
Okay, come on. I could read all of these names off, but we'll pass it out so everybody will have the names of those that we will focus on.
I'd like to hear
some more. Okay, I'd like to hear from more as well. Okay, Sister Denise, what do you do? Right, come on. Okay.
Well, sometimes, that's good. I like what she said about that. Calling people, sometimes you have to back off for a while because you feel like you're trying to talk, they can bother them, and you're trying to give them something that they don't want. And you kind of put them on the shelf, and maybe people will like, they want to take a while. One of the other things that might work, I've invited people, and they don't show up. After just several invitations, I'll say, and I know they have cars, they have transportation. Why don't I come back and pick you up? They say, oh no, I can come. You know, I can drive. And I said, no, I'll come back. I don't mind. I'll come back and pick you up. And sometimes they'll like, no, I'm gone. That works for some people, not everybody. That's why I say you have to assess the situation. See where people are.
Okay. All right. Good. Okay, now there are people that perhaps we would have problems with that are just sitting there that would offer no resistance at all. That would be people like maybe some of the spouses, I know one in particular that I'm looking at now, that he's always cordial. He doesn't come to church, but his wife is. member here. There's another one, a husband and a wife, which are kind of senile and not quite able to come hardly anymore. And they are people that would welcome you into their home. So we want to, we have a list, and they'll meet Sunday after church because we want to get this information out. And also we will discuss some other things that we will implement. Now, this is just people that possibly we could impact if we would just show them a little attention. In many cases, most of these cases, perhaps you can, some of them you could call, build a relationship with, visit, and very few of them probably would require a Bible study. But they just need for somebody to reach out to them. They're men, elderly men, they're young men, and there are young women, and then there are women, one or two, that's a little elderly. Okay, so we will get this. Now, the other thing, this is in the area of follow-up. In terms of what we have done in the past that we can continue to do that have been effective would be the financial peace class. I think this year we could have a lot more success with that because how many went through that class the last time? Okay, look at all these hands. Okay, and I think, the last time Jessica did it, it was a very successful course, and we had at least a dozen, is that right? I thought that was good, and I think that if people really knew what it was and how it could help them, I believe that many of them would get on board with that. But I think it will be necessary for those that went through that class to do what? To be the ones that will go out and what? Promote it, because I think you would be a lot more effective. How many believe that would be something that would attract attention? Now, we're going to talk about that a little bit more Sunday. And one new thing that we want to present Sunday after church is that we have a new course that we want to describe on marriage. And it's very similar, I understand, to financial peace. All of the publicity promotion of it has already been prepared. All of the information is in place. It's shared by BBD, and we want to present that, and we feel that this is something that we can implement real soon. So it won't be involving a whole lot of preparation, a lot of responsibility, but it will be something that's already ready to go that we can get together and determine when we want to do it, and we will try to organize a team to go out and promote it. And then we want to announce the time that we're going to implement that.
Okay, the goal is then, this, the focus is building the ministry as well as meeting the needs of people.
Right. So the people that's not coming, I think that this is the first, the first thing. We can do that right now. Is that right? We can get them back in place. Prayer will help. If we can get them to prayer, if we can call them, get them. I think some of these people will come to prayer if we persist a little bit. Okay, so I think that that would be something that we can do now. And Sunday, we can give you more information on that so that we can begin to move forward as we pray. How many believe prayer is important? But how many believe that faith without works is what? Dead. So now's the time for us to do what? We got to what? Do something. I would like, even this is a prayer, but I'm praying, I would like for us to pray that God will begin to send people across our path. How many believe that God can do that? Get somebody saved, you won't have to hunt them down and twist their arms and God. Oh, it was a blessing the other day. It was a young man that God, I've been praying about him for several months. I said, where in the world? I've been going all over looking for him. He used to have a shop. And everywhere I went, they said, he's not here no more. He's closed, shut down. Went over here, couldn't find him. I asked a couple of members, I said, do you know how to find him? No, we don't know. And the other day, I was up in a store, and here he comes. Ooh, answer to prayer. Oh, I just believe that that's a fish that's ready to be caught. Got a family and I say, ooh, hallelujah. So let's just pray. I mean, if y'all want the easy way out, pray that God will what? Send somebody across your path. That's good, ain't it? How many believe prayer will work for anything? I mean, everything. Jesus did it for everything before he even picked his disciples. He went off and what? Prayed so he would know which one to what? Pick. Amen. Everything he did, he what? Prayed about it. Amen. Before he what? He took action. All right, well, I wanted to get the ball rolling tonight, and we're going to finish this month out. Thank Brother Curtis, got in his man, 21 days of prayer, and so we will be here. This is the schedule. We're here every morning at 5 o'clock, and we're here till 5 to 6. We might stay at 5 or 10 minutes after 6, but we pretty well done by 6 a little after. Amen. We're going to do that the entire month. After then, we don't know which direction we'll go. I don't feel led to do it at night this month because I want to get out and begin to connect. Amen. Now, I'm going to put the ball in your court. Those of you, I'm not going to push anything off on you that you're not quite ready for. But if anybody here want to connect with me and say, Pastor Hill, who is it on your list that you can give me that I can hook up with? If you'll get the list Sunday, but if you can't wait until Sunday, just call me. All right?
And Sister Pearl.
All right, Sister Pearl. Amen. Praise God.
For those of you who have not heard, Color Craft Studio.